Whew. All right, guys, today I'll be telling you how I got this iPhone 11 for only $400 on Facebook Marketplace.
Don't give him the satisfaction.
What if I want the satisfaction?
And she see me, she knows this, yeah. And she screaming, she knows this, yeah. And she see me, she knows this, yeah.
I'm gonna share with you my process of how I worked out this deal so you can find value on Facebook Marketplace. Number one, I just used all my resources to find which phone looks the most quality. Checking the picture quality, looking at the descriptions, even looking at the profiles of the sellers. Do they look crazy? Do they look foreign? I'm just kidding. Do they look sketchy? Do they look sus? You know, you never know. So after I judged a book by its cover, I made sure to reach out, message each of these people who were selling iPhone 11s. I like to think of this next step as getting the sellers soft and malleable. You do this by communicating well and being fast with your replies. Also, use this time to humanize yourself, you know, express some emotions. Don't just be a dry buyer that doesn't really care about what they're getting. Most importantly, find out why they're selling and how many previous owners had this iPhone. Once you get the reasoning, this is your time to put in your initial offer. Lowball the heck out of them. And this isn't just you pulling a number out of thin air. You know, you gotta go and do your research, find out what the true value of this phone is, and maybe look up a price you can compare it to base off your initial offer. One thing I recommend is when you put out your initial offer, like here, don't give them a range, just give them a solid number. Also, I wouldn't recommend asking how low they're willing to go right off the bat. In some cases, you might do like a used car. In that case, asking for their best price might be a good tactic to get them to negotiate with themselves, and then you can put an offer even lower than that. So it may or may not work with an iPhone as well. Last but not least, I didn't just put an initial offer out there on its own. I made sure to find my competitive advantage that would justify a lower price. Like right here, I told her I can pick it up as soon as tomorrow to give her some convenience for a lower price. Not gonna lie, it's not a really good deal at all, but when people hear that, it's just kind of pleasing to the ear and less of a hassle. So in my process, after I put in my initial offer, she sent a counter offer right away. And so I just let that simmer, you know, let it cook on low for about a few hours, mainly just to show that I'm hard to please and skeptical and not easily persuaded. And that's important too. Be willing to walk away if the deal isn't good. Honestly, just don't get too excited. Be warm and cordial, but don't sound like you're desperate to get this phone right away. So before you counter their counter, make sure you have a basis for your negotiation. Like, start looking at the phone, start looking at what's included with it. I know my phone came with the charger and the headphones as well. So I just threw out there that, you know, I'll pay $400, but you can keep the headphones. That seemed to work pretty well. And instead of the hassle of taking apart this package, she just told me, screw it, you can take it for $400. And finally, the fourth step is the point of sale. At this point, we've already agreed on a price, but I didn't actually say that I'm gonna go meet her to pick it up. I just told her that I was there to check out the phone. Even if the deal is already popping, stay skeptical as you don't know what to expect once you meet the person. We decided to meet at Starbucks, and once she pulled up, I knew it was time to judge her. This lady, I'll call her Miranda, she pulls up in her nice clean Ford Fusion, and she happens to be bumping Christian rock. So she seemed pretty well put together. Once again, I'm generalizing and judging. From there, I introduced myself and asked her again why she decided to sell this phone. There wasn't any discrepancies in her story, so everything checked out. Because it was used, there was still risk, and I couldn't even go super far in examining the phone because she already put it on reset mode, and I couldn't just finish the final setup to be able to check through each and every one of the apps and settings or even the battery health. There's another video that I watched beforehand to know what to check out when I get a used iPhone. I'll put it in the description below, but those are important things to check. Just see how deeply you can examine your phone. Start with the exterior, of course, looking for any minor dents or bumps or scratches. Dents are a no-no. Look at the camera, make sure there aren't any scratches there, and just look for any maybe discrepancies in the display. From that point on, I was pretty comfortable making the purchase. I asked her what her most preferred payment was, and she said cash. So she stayed put, went to Bank of America, withdrew $400, and voila, I have my iPhone 11. And just a side note here, I made sure to tell her at the end that I would message her if I've had any technical questions or issues, just in case anything goes wrong. And this already established that there might be some post-purchase communication about the phone, but it wouldn't just be out of the blue for her if I reached out again. That's about it. Christmas is over, but you can still buy yourself a gift. Go just look on Facebook Marketplace, find deals, use common sense, and make sure to judge people. I love this phone, man. I love the camera. I love how fast it is. Best believe I'm gonna start vlogging on this baby. And yeah, I've never had an Apple phone before, so I'm now on the dark side. Now my text messages are blue. While you're here, make sure to subscribe, because I'll be uploading weekly. And I changed the name of this channel to The Unofficial JC. You can find me on Instagram, TikTok. I think that's it.